So why does all of this happen? Why has evolution left us with this kind of crosstalk between what's going on in our experience of life as mediated by the central nervous system and, if you will, sort of the molecular growth and development and differentiation of the white blood cell pool? So it used to be thought that these were, you know, essentially fundamentally distinct systems pursuing distinct agendas, that, for example, the brain's role was to perceive the external world and to develop essentially behavioral responses to that that helped us optimize our survival, that it helped us produce just the right behavior for the circumstances that were there in the ecology around us. And that the white blood cell's job was sort of analogous in the very, very small world of microbial responses. They're going to recognize the presence and activity of microorganisms and produce immune response to keep them in check. The reason it looks like these two systems have come to talk to each other is that there is a connection between what's going on in the external, if you will, sort of physical environment of the world and what's going on in our microbial environment. And that connection is somewhat more complex today than it was tens of thousands and maybe even hundreds of thousands and eventually millions of years ago. As far as we can tell, in under ancestral conditions of life, there was a pretty good connection between the experience of the world as threatening and unsafe and the likelihood that we would be wounded. That was one of the major ways that people died back when we were evolving out of sort of monkey lineage and early hominids. The dominant drivers of this were infectious diseases, the majority of which actually arrived through cuts and wounds. So when we're feeling threatened, the likelihood back then that we were going to be injured was pretty high because the things that threatened us were beasts that were going to eat us and hostile conspecifics who were mad at us because we'd done something to offend them or whatever. In either case, the likelihood that you're going to be wounded is pretty high, and wounds were quite frequently fatal back then, not so much because we were necessarily going to hemorrhage, but because we had all these bacteria in our guts and on our skin, and when someone wounds you, all that bacteria gets into what were previously relatively sterile tissues and grows like crazy. So this is one of the major ways that we used to die. Unfortunately, bacteria were not all we had to worry about. So what has happened as organisms become more social is they've built stronger antiviral responses because viruses do track on social existence. That's the major way they spread. So as species become more and more social, they develop generally stronger basal antiviral responses. So it looks like the reason we're programmed the way we are is because we have, as sort of the most social of all species we're aware of, a relatively strong basal antiviral state that then needs to get deviated when we're confronted with some sort of, if you will, stochastically high risk of infection with bacteria. So there became this association between experiences of threat, essentially, and the likelihood of needing a strong antibacterial response. And that's what created an incentive for our white blood cells to retool, to change, if you will, their basal transcriptional stance towards a particular type of pathogen that is now more likely to be encountered than under our basal circumstances. So as far as we can tell, that's at this point at least our best guess about why so many different types of adverse life circumstances seem to call forth such similar transcriptional responses in white blood cells, because they're all ways of feeling threatened or uncertain, as the moment that it looks like that's the nuclear core psychology of this particular gene expression trajectory. So like I said before, it looks like what's happening is we're taking a basal immune response that is particularly polarized against defending us against socially mediated viral infections, and under circumstances of threat or uncertainty, lightening up on that response so that we can produce a stronger deployment of this antibacterial, more kind of pro-inflammatory immune response. So you can think of that as reflecting, if you will, sort of two modes of operation in the white blood cell. One that sort of makes sense when we're under basal, safe, attached, socially enmeshed conditions, and another sort of more damage, or at least bacterial infection damage-related module that gets selectively activated when we experience ourselves as in danger, and for humans, because they're inherently social, that's almost analogous to being isolated. Isolation is another way to put it, is a better way to put it, is that isolation is relatively analogous to being in danger. In general, a lone human being is something else's lunch. In fact, the reason we rule the world, as many theorists have argued, is because of our ability to aggregate up in groups.